One technique that you probably want to be using a lot in your survey design is using groups of questions, groups that can get skipped over if they don't apply to the interviewee or respondent, or groups of questions that can be repeated in loops and asked again and again. Well, in this video, I'm going to show you exactly what a group of questions is and how you can use it. Here's an example of what a group of questions getting skipped in a survey might look like. So we might start at the top with, do you give consent? And if no, we would just end the survey right then and there. If yes, we'd continue to section one. And then there might be some decision that says, do you want to keep going? No, we would end the survey, or yes, we'd go to section two. This keeps on going all the way to the last section of the survey or questionnaire, and then we'd say, do you want to end? And yes, and we end the survey. So that's a really basic example of how you can use groups of questions in a survey to keep on going through the survey or to jump to the end of the survey or to jump to different sections. What does this practically look like? This is a survey I'm currently running, and what we want to do, and most of the time, most questionnaires and surveys will always start with something like consent. So I might have a question around, this is the purpose of collecting the data, and someone will say, okay. And then another question pops up, and this is how I'm going to store the data, okay. And this is just telling them you can skip questions, what we're getting to, if you want to, okay. And are you okay to contribute your data to the survey? I'd love to include your perspective. So this is where we have that decision point. From our flowchart, do you give consent, yes or no? And so we're either going to jump to section one or the end of the survey. So if we say no, you didn't give consent, so now the interview is done. Thank you. And the person can submit. If they say yes, it's going to take them into one more question and then the section one questions. Okay, so I've put in some responses to section one, and then I've come to the last section or the last question of the section, and it says, you're 10% done. How are you feeling? So there's two responses. I love surveys. Let's keep going. Or I'm not really a survey person. I'm already tired of this. Take me to the end of the survey now. And that's a great example of the end of section one. Do you want to keep going? Yes or no? So if we say, I'm not really a survey person, I'm already tired of this, take me to the end of the survey, we ask a few follow-up questions, and then when you're all done, you can submit. That's if you just want to end. If you just say, I love surveys, let's keep going, it's going to take you to section two, where we can keep filling in responses. This is a great example that every form designer or survey designer can use depending on your context and sector. And finally, let's just jump into the survey in the background to check out how these groups and the skipping actually works. So this is an XLSForm. If you want a copy of it, I want you to go, there's a link in the description below, and I want you to go and take the survey. If you take the survey at the end, it just takes you to a page where you can download this example XLSForm. So that's a little perk for actually contributing to the survey. So I'd love you to get your hands on this, but I'm going to show you how these groups work in the XLSForm version. So when you've got your consent group, you can see that at the beginning and the end of a group of questions, I put begin group and end group. And that just means the questions that are between these two rows are all in a group, okay? And at the end, so this one here says, I'd like to include your perspective. Are you okay to contribute to the data, your data to the survey? This question is called consent. And so the very next group, I've called it the consent group. And this group is around the whole survey. Okay, there are hundreds of lines in this survey. And you can see right at the end, there's the end group is the consent group, okay? So all of the questions in the whole survey are all part of a single group, okay? And so I've made that possible there. And I have another video on how to make a consent group, so I'll link that in the description below. But all we put in the relevant column over here is if consent equals yes, then you would enter this group of questions. And if that is not true, if consent does not equal yes, it'll just skip that whole group. It just won't even ask, okay? And that is how you kind of use groups. Now, if we kind of carry on, each section then of the survey has a group, okay? And then within each section of the group, I have other groups. So say this is a person who works, okay? This is a worker. This is these are the questions for a volunteer. These are the questions for a student. So I basically made a group of questions for students, a group of questions for volunteers, a group of questions for workers. And all I've done is I've asked a question at the beginning, you a worker, a volunteer, or a student. And whatever they say, I will just say in the relevant column, if they selected work, ask this type, this group of questions. If they selected volunteer, ask this group of questions. If they selected student, ask this group of questions. Hopefully that gives you a little bit of an introduction to actually how you do that. I would love if you go and take the survey, download it, and have a peek, have a play with this XLS form yourself. If you would like to actually study with me and learn how to make complex XLS forms yourself, then I would love it if you join the waitlist for my program Mastering Form Design in Kobo Toolbox. So I'll put that link in the description below. If you enjoy videos like this, give it a thumbs up, hit subscribe if you want to stay connected with me in the future, and I'll see you next time. Bye.